Today's a big day. After 2 years, I finally have the 280Z at a Rallycross. Today I am at the Southern Iowa Speedway. This is not the usual grass course that we run with this group, but this is more of a hard-packed dirt course. We will be using some of the dirt oval today. As you can see, the course is going to use a lot of the dirt oval, and then it uses the access roads on the infield as well. It has been sprinkling all morning, so the track is wet, and I think it's going to rain the rest of the day.
All right, thank you everybody for coming out. We've got a lot of new faces. It's pretty awesome. I'm glad a bunch of people are coming out to try this out. So Rallycross is a little bit different than autocross if you've done it before. Autocross is your fastest lap of the day. That's it. It doesn't matter. You can have shitty laps. It doesn't, you know, doesn't hurt you. Rallycross is cumulative. Everything counts. So you want to be clean and fast from the get-go. Vertical cones are a 2-second penalty. If you knock them down or knock them off, there's a paint dot under every single one. If you knock them up and it's still up but it's off your paint dot, that's a 2-second penalty. If you go, these are pointers telling you the correct side to go on. If you take out the cone and hit the pointer isn't any extra penalty. If you're on the wrong side and run over the pointer, don't get the cone, that's a 10-second penalty.
Right, yeah.
You're out here on the wrong side, so you want to stay on course.
So there's no DNF?
Or? No DNF.
Okay.
You take a 10-second penalty for
which,
each element you go on the wrong side of, so you can hurt yourself.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah. So if you can't dive and take the cone out, if you're out of sorts, then you only get 2 seconds of penalty instead of 10. So
that's actually,
it's well worth it.
I got 666 on the line.
34. One cone for 96. Confirming another cone.
E on deck, R18.
They just called a break. The surface is completely polished. It's been sprinkling or raining this whole time, and it's just not safe enough to continue right now. So we have an hour break. Hopefully this rain lets off, things dry up. So if we can get the water off of this surface, it should be very grippy. Things are drying up now, so we're gonna switch to my group and I'm going to go out there.
Thank you.
just finished my first run. It was a bit difficult because it is still wet out there. There's a lot of dry areas too. So not only was it my first time on course, but it's hard to gauge what is wet and what is dry. So I oversteered a couple places a little too far. I think it's just going to get dry from now on, so it should get a lot more consistent out there. Well, that was a good time and a perfect test of the car. My car was showing some high water temps, but beyond that, it finished all of the runs. I can't say that about some of the other cars here. Time to go back to the shop and make some more improvements. What a difference a couple hours makes. The first group is ready to go out. This was the group that was running when it was just pouring down and we had to stop because it got too slick. This is the neat thing about Rallycross over Autocross is the course is going to be different every time and the conditions are always changing.
53 on deck, 53. 1-8 plus 1.
Your call, you said 11's done.
That's correct.